Hello and welcome to our final webcast at Autodesk University 2020. It is so hard to believe we've reached the last day, but just like the in-person event, time flies when you're having fun. So thanks for joining us. Today you're going to hear from Mike Ivanov, our Content Technical Services team lead. Mike's going to speak to us today on how e-learning impacts digital transformation. If we haven't met already, my name is Tiffany Willard. I'm a Global Business Development Specialist here at Eagle Point, and I will be your moderator for today's session. Before we get started, I would like to cover just a few housekeeping items. This webcast is going to be recorded for replay purposes. It will be provided to you after the session. We're going to leave time for question and answer for Mike at the end, so feel free to submit your questions at any point throughout the presentation. You can do this by typing your question in the Q&A box there at the below in your console. If you have any technical questions, let us know. Someone will be available to troubleshoot with you. Also, I wanted to make note that everyone is muted. You're going to be remaining muted throughout the entire webcast. So again, if you have any questions, you can communicate that with us in the Q&A box. As for the agenda, we're going to start out with introductions. I'll give a brief explanation of who Eagle Point Software is. I'll turn things over to Mike, and of course, we're going to wrap things up with Q&A. As for introductions, Mike Ivanov again is our presenter, and for over 14 years he has worked in learning, education, and content development. Prior to joining the Eagle Point team, Mike led a group of content developers at McGraw-Hill Higher Education. There he created new learning technologies for higher education fields in multiple disciplines. Mike is passionate about helping others through learning opportunities. As for me, again, my name is Tiffany Willard, Global Business Development Specialist. I joined Eagle Point back in 2009, and it's really been exciting to see Pinnacle Series grow in adoption, not only in the Americas, but globally. My area of expertise is talking with individuals who are responsible for driving digital transformation on the front end of our sales process. So whether your organization is small, mid-size, or large enterprise, everyone really experiences the same pain points that Pinnacle Series is designed to solve. As for who Eagle Point Software is, we have a long-standing history in the AEC market. John Beaver, our president and CEO, started the company believing there had to be a way to leverage technology better, faster, and produce exceptional work. So as time moved on, our product offerings have changed, but our vision has not. In 2006, Pinnacle Series came to market. Pinnacle Series is the leading e-learning system designed specifically for architecture, engineering, construction, and manufacturing. Today, we have over 200,000 global users. And I think it's important to note that we are in the Autodesk Developer Network, and we're also an authorized publisher. We're really honored to be a part of that elite group. Autodesk goes through and picks only just a handful of publishers that have high quality content. I'll wrap up by mentioning that we do have a growing network of Pinnacle Series resellers worldwide. And with all of that being said, I will now turn it over to Mike Ivanov. Mike?
Hey, thank you, Tiffany, very much. So I'm going, as she said earlier, I'm going to jump right into the presentation and begin talking about what is a digital transformation. Thank you so much for that introduction. As Tiffany said, I am a former college professor. I'm also a lifelong learner, and I come from McGraw-Hill Higher Education. I'm bringing that up because my mission is really to help people succeed with learning. And today we're going to cover some topics about digital transformation and how e-learning platforms like the Pinnacle Series help to alleviate some of the pain points that go along with this. I brought up my background at MHE simply because I want to talk about the digital transformation that we went through while I was at that company. When I started at McGraw-Hill Higher Education, approximately 90% of the revenue that we made was from a traditional print product. We all know what McGraw-Hill is famous for, textbooks. We've all paid the prices for them. I assure you they're worth the quality. But what we saw from the time I started at the company to the time I ended with the company is almost a complete reversal in how we were operating our business. As I said, we went from a 90% print business to greater than 50% digital business. And this was more than just a digitization of the text into a format that could be used on a computer. It included revamping our entire system of assessments, of how we approached learning, of how we delivered the content. And so this really caused a structural and operational change within McGraw-Hill. And since the time of COVID in this spring, I'm sure that they are only seeing greater digital demand than they ever have before. But what is considered a digital transformation and how does it differ entirely from just simple digitization? Well, within a digital transformation, what you really need is an integration of technology. So something that could be game changing. You need to see a difference in the digital processes and a difference in the digital competencies of the group or company that we're working with. And it doesn't happen haphazardly. It has to happen in a very staged and strategic progression. So when I came to Eagle Point earlier this year to head up the content development team, I was really excited to see how much of a digital transformation the AEC space has already made. There's a smart integration of technology into this business. And after COVID, that's only going to be accelerating, and we need to be more resilient in how we look at our digital transformations. The keynote speaker for the Autodesk University event, Andrew Aganas, said the digital transformation is already here. And when you look at the A and E spaces, absolutely. And he really highlighted the C space, the construction space, and it definitely is happening. Digital transformations happen in our everyday lives. And so I've kind of separated three different main groups about digital transformation because I want to kind of show the progression of how digital transformation is impacting the AEC space in particular. When we look at our everyday lives in things like transportation, Uber is a great example of this. They went from taking the traditional riding experience, the transportation experience that you would have with a taxi, and creating a digital transformation in which we interact, process, and go through payment all in a digital field. So it's more than just taking the ride, or it's more than just taking the interaction and putting it on your phone. It's creating a process that was entirely different than the one that we had and one that we all soon adopted. Print, as I said before, with my background at McGraw-Hill, is something that's pretty near and dear to my heart. But when you look at traditional printers and the digital transformation that they've had to make, whether they be in the textbook industry or in the newspaper industry, for instance, there's more than just taking the text that they ordinarily would have produced and putting it on the computers. There's integrating different technologies such as social media and understanding how to communicate better with their audiences. And then finally, this is one that's really been impacted by COVID lately, and that's the retail transactions that we all do every day. There's a local retailer here in my hometown in business for over 80 years. When COVID hit, they had to shut their door. They couldn't do their normal transactions. So what they had to do is they had to create a social media presence. They had to create a retail store that was online, and they had to begin to make a digital transformation because they were forced to do so. In our careers, traditionally, when we think of digital transformations for our companies, we've seen this take place in the HR field for quite a long time. HR deals with a lot of important, sensitive information year to year, and they have really adopted a process that allows them to be able to share that information through the entire process or through our entire careers. With COVID-19, meetings have really seen an increase in their digital transformation. As we know now, I'm giving this meeting, you know, to all of you via a Zoom or a Teams meeting format. That's something that we would have never done even a year ago. And this is something that is changing the way that we operate in our day-to-day lives. I think very few of us would argue that when we all get back to normal, whatever normal is after COVID, the way that we handle meetings and communications and company procedures is going to change drastically, and it's going to become more and more digital as we move forward. And then lastly, and this is where the e-learning platform really begins to shine, is in skill-specific digital transformation. So as our keynote speaker talked about before, data transfer is becoming very digital. Planning and project execution is becoming incredibly digital. And it seems like a no-brainer that when we look at our entire field, this is where we're going to want to be going in a digital transformation. Let's make this happen. but it's oftentimes not that easy. There are three major barriers to any digital transformation. They are cost, the amount of money it takes to adopt the technology, train the people that are there, and get that technology online or that digital transformation finished, the time it takes to do all those things, and of course, the skills gap. So I have a couple statistics here that allow us to kind of see digital transformations from a holistic view when we look at the entire economy. And one of the most startling statistics that I found and is that 70% of digital transformations actually fail. And it's often due to a resistance from employees because it requires additional time for training. It requires additional time for overcoming that skills gap. And oftentimes it requires a cost in making sure that employee is trained to do what they need to do because of this digital transformation. When we look at the overall amount of money spent just in 2018. Now I looked this statistic up again, and for 2020, we're up to about 1.8 trillion, and I'm not sure of the exact amount that's being wasted, but as of 2018, we were wasting almost 900 billion because these initiatives were not meeting their goal. And so we're seeing that these barriers are real. When we're looking at how we're going to transform a business through digital means, these are impactful numbers that we need to remember. And then lastly, only 55% of an organization believe their current workforce is aligned well to make the digital initiative happen. So typically, why do these efforts fail? It's because the digital transformation that's being performed lacks clearly defined goals and objectives. And the process breaks down because of frustration that takes place on the employee side and on the management side as well. One thing. So what are effective ways to overcome this, I should say? It's an e-learning solution, obviously. So through the implementation of an e-learning solution, we can really target those three barriers that we talked about before. A digital transformation requires that the organization change all the existing models. So when you look at what's happening within the organization, you need to be prepared to make a change from what you do on your everyday life. The skills training has really morphed. When you look at how COVID has affected how we train, we can see that we're no longer going to be able to do instructor-led courses, and that personalized targeted e-learning paths are really going to be the way of the future if we want a digital transformation to take place. When we think about the amount of time and money that would have been needed to send someone to a normal instructor-led course where they can now get that through an e-learning solution, it makes a lot of sense in the new world for us to be able to pursue that e-learning path. I had a really great conversation in the preparation of this talk with Dan Gallivan from Payette Architectural Solutions. And he is their information technology director. And we talked a lot about the applications of digital into their business currently and what COVID has done for their business. And he really pointed out to me that when you look at a lot of businesses, and this goes back to the statistic I was talking about before, when you look at a lot of businesses, when they apply something digital or they look to make a digital transformation, they often don't implement it linearly within the business, meaning that it's disjointed. So an e-learning solution can help improve the success of that digital transformation by allowing better communication and collaboration between all of the groups that are there taking place and taking part in that digital transformation. And so we need to understand first and foremost that those three barriers, one of the most important things to overcome those three barriers is how does information flow between all of the stakeholders that are represented within the company? Well, it's knowledge sharing. I love this little graphic here because it's a fortune cookie. My kids love to break open fortune cookies and look at that little piece of information or whatever it is, the fortune that they're being told. And I really like this as a metaphor to how knowledge is being shared. It's this little nugget that needs to be remembered. And so when I had my discussion with Dan at Payette, he revealed how important collaboration and knowledge sharing is for his company in their successful transition through the digital frontier. So prior to COVID, They had a work environment that was very similar to what you're seeing on that picture. Multiple team members could get together, they could talk, they could discuss, and they could really identify and look at problems. This collaborative environment helped them to assess how they were doing, and it was really what made Payette such a dynamic company to work for. COVID hits this spring and they're no longer able to collaborate anymore. So the knowledge sharing really broke down. And he revealed to me that by having an e-learning platform that allowed for work groups and information to be shared seamlessly between the different work groups, they were able to keep that collaboration running and even expand on it. So they brought in a team site and they also used the sketching there so they could do real world or real time edits on their drawings, and they can solve these problems together. I looked up a nice statistic here I got from Forbes magazine, and that if you have poor knowledge sharing practices within your company, for the Fortune 500 companies at least, it's costing us $31.5 billion annually. So it's nothing to, you know, to really shake a stick at. It's a lot of money out there when communication is not adequately being illustrated or being realized. So real-time collaboration helps overcome digital transition barriers, but what happens if you lose a group member maybe on a project? So for instance, when I left McGraw-Hill, I know for a fact that the practices unfortunately weren't not there for knowledge capture. When I left in February, I wasn't required to transfer any of my knowledge to my my team when I left. So I got lots of phone calls, lots of emails later on about, hey, can you tell me more about this project? Can you help me here? If we would have had at McGraw-Hill a place to place all of our best practices and that knowledge that I had when I decided to leave, it would have been a much easier transition for my team, and they could have hit the ground running a little bit faster. So what is knowledge capture? Knowledge capture is the process by which we convert the tacit, the stuff that's inside of my brain, into an explicit form that can be shared. So if we can think of any days that when we can think about the first days you may have started on a project or a new job, you always can think about there was someone there, or there typically was someone there that you could go to ask. And because we live in a new COVID world, you have less and less capabilities, unless you have an e-learning system, to be able to find somebody to help you get on board and get moving quickly. With an e-learning system holding that knowledge in one place, it can act as your single source of truth and really get you through those pain points that happen when you transfer projects or transfer a job. So although the digital transformation within the AEC industry has taken, you know, has really begun maybe 40 years ago, it's only going to continue to accelerate. When we think about what our keynote speakers have told us in this conference, they've told us time and time and time again, data transfer, process management, and digital technology are the wave of the future, and that's what we're really pushing. So how do companies avoid being part of the 70% that fail when they try to make a digital transformation? At the end of the day, you have to do your homework. So a digital transformation to be successful requires in-depth understanding of those pain points. It requires understanding those three barriers to the success of your company and making sure you're identifying solutions for all three of those. It requires that all the knowledge that you're creating be accessible to everybody within the team, and that you don't silo the work assignments. You need to encourage collaboration and teamwork. Through that collaboration and teamwork, people can be more successful and embrace the change. Recall that statistic earlier said, a lot of times it fails because it lacks employee engagement. So what you need to do in order to successfully have a digital transformation take place at your company, is you need to embrace the change and push a culture which embraces the change. I had a great interview with Carl Storms. He's the BIMTRAC Technical Solutions Lead. They are a cutting edge technology company that has been making digital transformation part of their everyday process for a number of years. And he said it the best, I thought. It's the willingness and the ability to change which sets successful companies apart from the crowd. And only in that ability and that willingness to change can your company succeed through a digital transformation. Well, thank you, and I would be happy to answer any questions that you have.
Okay. It looks like there are a couple questions that came in.
Yeah.
So the first one, Mike, is our company is currently in a digital transformation. I think it might fail. What can we do?
Yeah, the answer is many times when it comes to a digital transformation, you're not necessarily failing. You're maybe stuck. And so the best thing that you can do at this point is to reevaluate your goals and the outcomes that you want from that digital transformation, and then reevaluate what's possible for you to get finished. Once you know that those pieces are in place, you can begin to start the process again. So it's you have to have a clear vision, you have to have an understanding of where it is you need to go in order for that digital transformation to take place.
Okay. I don't know if you can hear me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what are on the next frontiers in the AEC around digital transformation?
Yeah, I think the biggest frontier for digital transformation in our field is AI, the application of AI to our real world problems. I can see AI really setting the pace for how we approach new problems in our field and continue to look at solutions. I can see AI affecting everything from the e-learning solution, where we understand better how people learn, to being able to plan better the impacts of projects down the road. I see the partnership between Spacemaker and Autodesk as one in which we can see the power of AI being realized by one of the largest players in the industry.
Okay, thanks, Mike. So the next question is, how do you know when you have arrived? When is digital transformation finished?
It never is, right? I mean, when we think about how digital transformation has taken place, it started 40 years ago, and it'll continue for 40 years more. We're always going to be challenged by new technology and disruptions to the market. In the case what I talked about before with AI being a disruption to the market, it's a good disruption, of course, but it's one in which we need to make sure we're transforming and understanding. COVID is an example of a negative impacting force on the market, and it will require us to do more and more to transform digitally as well. So the simple answer is it never ends. However, each individual digital transformation project can be accomplished, and then we're going to have to start in on another one.
Okay, I think that's going to be all the questions that have come in at this point. So I think we'll go ahead and wrap things up. I do want to make note that Autodesk University will be leaving Eagle Point's booth open and accessible for 30 days from the start of the conference. And one of our colleagues, Tara Verdia, sat down with two of our clients who talked about almost digital transformation, but also technology adoption and what that, you know, really digital transformation was the kind of final point in her live session that she did here at our booth yesterday. But just want to make note that you guys can search for her talk. You can bookmark it. You can watch it on demand. All of the on-demand Autodesk classes will be on the website for an entire year. So encourage you to check that out. You know, Mike talked a lot about Pinnacle Series throughout the presentation for knowledge capture and training. If you are interested in learning about Pinnacle Series, feel free to reach out to myself. I'd love to set up a time to talk with you one-on-one, and we can look at exploring the possibilities of Pinnacle for your organization. If you do have other questions for Mike, don't hesitate to reach out. Both of our contact information is located at our booth. Certainly reach out to him. So we appreciate your time today. We hope that you enjoyed today's session and enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you.
Thanks.